Alright, so where am I here? I'm early in the morning on discussion of, I don't know, it's not RLS, it's not sleeping leg syndrome, more sleeping body syndrome, but no, it is a numbing of the legs, it's numbing sometimes to my cheekbones and my face. And I'm like, well, I don't know, I've been here in this situation for, and yet I love this voice, yes, my voice is still repairing from singing. I don't know, I believe since, for sure, 2009, I think it's been maybe 4, 5, 6 years, possibly longer, of determinant sitting. Anytime I'm sitting down, I go numb. When I lay down, I go numb, like literally. So I have a body creeping numb syndrome. If somebody calls to the door, if I'm stuck in an absolute, I guess I'll call it a paralysis syndrome. If I'm stuck, I have to stand, you know, and it takes me quite a while to get out of it. And so to stand out of it is like, well, sometimes I have to hurry if it's my father, because I don't know, I don't want to tell my father all these things because he is such a hypochondriac type about my health. And yet he knows I'm the one who drives the car with one leg and then I switch to the other. He knows that already, so I guess he knows there is something wrong. So anyhoot, yeah, and so the phone is ringing way back there, and many times in France the phone is ringing. I can't answer the phone. The door is being whatever. Somebody's knocking on the door. I can't get to the door. So there's a time frame when there's a freeze on the body. The body's frozen to the wake-up stage. So I'm in the body frozen stage to the wake-up stage. And it takes maybe, I don't know, it could take two minutes, 3 minutes. So, you know, depending on the distance I have to go, you know. And then there's the standing, and when you're on the final stand, there's the flood, and I will call it the flood out stage, when the body is still going through the tremors of, you're still asleep, you know, the body is still asleep. And it's scary to talk to people when your body is numb. It is scary. So in preference, I don't want to answer the door. In preference, I don't even want to answer the telephone. So it's an odd reclusion of disability, that the body is just saying, just forget it. Let's just be head talkers. Let's just talk through our heads like Stephen Hawking. You know, let's just forget it. Just give up. You know, but I'm like, no, I can go to the gym, I can drive that distance, I can go to the gym, and then I can dance for maybe an hour, you know. But then I'm dead. You know, I'm just dead after. And then I'm like, well, and then I'm databasing. And I'm like, well, how's that fair? How is that fair that I'm just a database worker? And I can't really move my legs? How is that fair? How is that fair and just? You know, and yet I am damned by my family as an unemployed. How is that fair? Are they the type of people that do kick, you know, kick the cripple? Is that my family? The kick the cripple family? Oh, she's walking. I saw her walking. Yeah. That's me walking. My particular situation is different. I sit down, I don't walk anymore for a long time. It's just the way it goes. You got to see me walking. That's the difference. I don't know what it is. I had a friend in Germany, and he had it. He just couldn't move his legs anymore. He went to doctor. And they just said, no more dancing, you can't do ballet. And I just think that was the wrong tune that they gave him, the wrong answer. They do these types of things, you know, they say, no more. You know. I just think it's wrong. So anyhoot, yeah. I don't know. You know, like I told my little brother yesterday, I'm like, well, yeah, so it creeps up the legs, whatever, and I'm stuck. I'm just stuck. You know. My father needs something, and I'm stuck. You know, I'm just like a doll who can't move, literally. You know. And I'm like, well, I have to muster the strength. Do you understand the words? Muster the strength to crawl. So I have to muster the strength to crawl, and then I have to muster the strength to answer the door. And it's not a fun life. So what? Did you write down somewhere that I'm a bitch? Alright, so anyway, good morning. And then what is the next phrase? I was out. No, she doesn't answer the telephone. I get tired of crawling to its ring. Do you understand? I believe I listed this on my website a long time ago. If you chose not to read, if you chose not to listen, you just chose to stipulate an ordinate me as some kind of yourself. Well, then that's your deal. So anywho. So yeah, so I'm just attacked, aren't I? I'm attacked because everyone thinks I'm some major slacker. I'm thinking I'm a major slacker. And well, yeah, I guess so. But is it fair that I have to database all day? Is it fair that I have to look at this, what do you call it? I don't know. I was looking at my deep paint or whatever that I worked on, you know, the little screenshot of that last vlog I put out there. And I'm like, well, I don't know if I really want to work for any company and make things hop around. I just don't. I just feel like this whole thing has just become just a pusher, a hype pusher, you know? Do I cry sometimes because of it? Yeah. But that's not the point. Why is my body shutting down? You know, and I'm looking, well, it's not my mother's syndrome. It's not my mother's syndrome at all. She didn't have it. Not this particular way. Hers was different. She went, I don't know. We attribute it to estrogen overdoses. She took estrogen overdoses from certain, I don't know, pill companies back in the 60s. So I attribute everything that happened to her from those. But no, I'm not ever along her same track. She had action and motivation quite a long way. Through her end game. She could get up and move, and she was quite physical. So yeah, so now here, so here. So I'm like, well, so I try to contact my brother, my little brother. I'm like, okay, well, gee, you know, I'll let you know. You know, does that happen to you? Does it happen to you, little brother? But he doesn't write me back. He doesn't call me back. He doesn't contact me. So now I have to query, you know, what? You wrote me off, you blocked me because you think I'm a slacker. Anywho, so I have some Teddy Roosevelt disease, or what do we call it, that, you know, he had to be a politician also, that guy. And then, yeah, we go back to King Edward. We'll go back to King Edward, you know. He was himself sequestered in quite a, you know, a reclusion state. Purposeful, because he was weak. He was weak his whole life. His body was weak his whole life. So he went and he led England, and he had the Hundred Years' War and all of that. The bubonic plague began, the Black Plague. And all of that went on, and he was a total, you know, weak leader physically. He was a weak leader physically. Perhaps that's why he lived sequestered, because he didn't want people to see that he was, you know, frail, fragile, and possibly a kickover, you know, because as a leader back then, you can't be a kickover. You know, just could not have been a kickover. Anyway, I don't know. And then there's that one dude, that Vogue guy with that kid, and he brings up that kid with his MS legs or whatever. I don't know if it is alive any longer or not, but that particular line version in Scotland goes on and on about it. And I'm like, well, yes, so maybe we're related to that, and it's so. There's no reason to abuse me and make me here do this website thing where I have to keep uploading databases for a little chump change and then saying I'm unemployed. This is ridiculous. Nor is it a reason to march me into a medical establishment. Because it's definitely hereditary defect. So I have hereditary defect. My choice is not to go to medical establishment. My husband's gran, they just chopped off her leg. Do you understand? They're still doing that type of action. They just cut her leg off. Yeah, I'm not really dealing well with, you know, what they call an upgrade here, modern times. Women's breasts hacked off, you know, legs cut off. Elderly, old people that were gonna die anyway, you know, within a year, just let's cut off their legs. You know? It's pretty sick. It's a pretty sick group. And I disown you, I disown all of you, and no, you do not have rights. You do not have rights to my body to use in experimentation, because I do not have enough money. You do not have rights to use my body in any way, shape, or form for experimental purposes, or even purposes of what you deem or deign correct and just and true as approvable, cure. So no, you do not have rights to submit me to any medical institution. Do you understand? Any medical doctor, you do not have rights. Anyway, yeah, well, I don't really like your jurification over me.